In order to simplify this expression, following the order of operations, we need to simplify inside the parentheses first. So for the first step, we'll determine the sum of 2/3 and 3/5. So we know we'll have to determine a common denominator in order to add these fractions. And for 2/3 and 3/5, the least common denominator would be 15. 15 is the smallest number that is divisible by both 3 and 5, and it's also the least common multiple of 3 and 5. So we're going to rewrite both of these fractions with denominators of 15. So for 2/3, we'll have to multiply the denominator and the numerator by 5. And for 3/5, we'll have to multiply the denominator and the numerator by 3. Notice how now we have a common denominator of 15. So we'll have 10/15 plus 9/15. So now we can determine this sum. We'll have 5/6 minus, this will be 19/15. And now the last step is to determine this difference. So now we need to determine the least common denominator with a denominator of 6 and 15. So we want the smallest number that is divisible by both 6 and 15, or the least common multiple of 6 and 15. And that would be 30. So we'll have to multiply this first fraction by 5 over 5, to multiply this fraction by 2 over 2. So now we'd have 25/30 minus, would be 38/30. And now the last step is to determine this difference. So the denominator is going to stay the same, that would be 30, and then the numerator would be 25 minus 38, which would be negative 13. So negative 13 over 30, but since this fraction is negative, a lot of times you'll see the negative out in front of the fraction bar like this. These two fractions are equivalent, but this form is more common. I hope this was helpful.